once again, let's review where we are now. We now have a descent method. We have concluded that we should pick our next search direction to be a conjugate after having picked all of the previous search directions to be a conjugate with respect to each other. But notice that we cannot pick a search direction such that it is orthogonal to the current residual, because if we do, then this alpha k is equal to zero, and therefore our next guess is just equal to our current guess, and therefore we're not making any progress in this step. So the question really is, well, there are two questions. One is, are there a-conjugate directions to be had? Do they even exist? And the second one is, if they exist, is there one that is not perpendicular to the current residual? All right, well, let's have a look at the first question. The first question is, if we look at the set of all vectors that are a-perpendicular to the previous search directions, that's really saying that it's the set of all p that are perpendicular to the span of a times the first search direction, etc., all the way through a times the last search direction. Okay? If there are at most n minus one of these, then this at most spans an n minus one dimensional space, and therefore there should be vectors that are perpendicular to it. So we conclude there are a conjugate directions as long as we haven't already explored n of those so far. Okay, so now we go on and we say, okay, is any of those directions not perpendicular to the current residual? And the argument goes as follows. Well, we know that the current residual is b minus a times the current approximation. And we can write our current approximation as a linear combination of the previous search direction. So this is just a vector of all of these coefficients that you see right here, except for the last one. And notice that because we chose all of these directions to be a conjugate, this term disappears and we're left with that P is perpendicular to B. So if P is perpendicular to the current residual, then P is also perpendicular to our original right-hand side, B. But what does that mean? If all P that are a conjugate to the previous search directions are perpendicular to the current residual, then notice that because P is perpendicular to the span of these A, P, 0, etc. vectors, inherently then B must actually be in that space, that span. Okay? Because this is the set of all vectors that are perpendicular to all P that are A conjugate to the previous search directions. So, inherently that means that B can be written as a linear combination of A times the first search direction and so forth through A times the last search direction that we explored. Now, if you think about it, xk minimized f of x over all the space spanned by all previous search directions, that was by assumption. And what that really means is that it minimizes the 2 norm of this. I should correct that. So notice that if you stare at this hard enough, what you conclude is that B is a linear combination of the span of A times all of these search directions. A times X is in that span. A times XK was in that span, but minimized this expression. And therefore, xk must have the property that b is equal to a times xk. And what does that mean? That means that in the previous iteration, we actually had found our solution. It means that rk, therefore, is actually the zero vector because it's the residual. and therefore we never would have gotten to the point where we needed to pick a new search direction because we already had found our solution. The upshot of all of this is, okay, if we get to this point right here, then we can find a new search direction that is A-conjugate to all of the previous directions and that is not perpendicular to the current residuum. Therefore, in this current step, we will make progress.